Tomorrow, a new speeding crackdown will start, but it's not where you might think. KCRA3's Richard Sharp joins us now live from Yuba City with why speeding is the number one complaint to police in that department.
Yeah, Galston, these portable radar signs behind me here are usually on bigger, busier streets. Not this time. The police department is relying on people who live in Yuba City to tell them where to put the signs. You don't need a radar sign to know how fast people are driving through quiet neighborhoods like this one in Yuba City. Just ask the people who live here.
How fast do you see some people going?
Oh, I've seen them exceed 50, 60.
Oh, 50, 60, sometimes. I mean,
50 or 60 on a 25-mile-an-hour street?
Oh, yeah, I just fly down.
Even though there are thousands more drivers and plenty of collisions on busier, faster roads like highways 99 and 20, police say it's almost as dangerous on residential streets because there are more people on the sidewalks and crosswalks. Last year, speed accounted for close to 30% of collisions that cause injuries in neighborhoods.
The number one complaint we get is speeding in neighborhoods. So what we do, our traffic unit looks at that and decides which area is having the most complaints come in, and that's the area we focus on.
When the radar sign went up in front of her house on Helen Avenue, Linda Burris was relieved.
We've got children that live across the street and children down the street, and they play, and I am so scared to death that someday somebody is going to hit them.
The goal of the speeding crackdown is not to ticket drivers, but educate them. In fact, ticketed drivers can get the fine dismissed if they attend a two-hour driver safety class. People who live here hope drivers get the message before someone gets hit.
A car will go whizzing by real fast, and we'll yell out, "Slow down," and they look at us and laugh.
Neighbors who live along streets like this say the number one offenders of speeding they see on streets like this one, teenagers going to and from high school, second in line, commuters headed to and from work. Now, the program begins tomorrow. Each month, the police department will focus on a couple of different neighborhoods throughout the year. Live in Yuba City, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 19.